Hello friend, last time we discussed about the difficulties in measurement in national income. And there are two types of difficulties, the conceptual and theoretical difficulties and statistical, or we call the practical difficulties. Today we now discuss the another point and last point in the chapter number 2, national income 2.4, the circular flow of income and expenditure. So 2.1, we see the meaning and importance of national income. Then we see the some concept of GNP, NNP, GDP, per capita income, the personal income, disposable income, the measurement of national income by the product method, income method, and the expenditure method, and difficulties. Today we see the 2.4, the circular flow of income two sector model. So 2.4 is circular flow of income and expenditure. It is the our new point. The next we see that the what is mean by national income. Just revise what is mean by national income. So national income in India we start the measuring in the from the committee. National Income Committee was founded by Indian government in August 1949 under the leadership of P.C. Mahanobis, is the chairman, and the two main members, the economist Professor Dhananjay Gargi, Dr. V.K. R.V. Rao is the other member. And before that, the national income measurement, the year of 1867, the Dada Bhai Nauroji, the first tried to calculate the national income of India. And the National Income Committee is given the definition of the national income. National estimate measure the volume of commodities and services turned out during given period of counted without duplication. So within one economic year, the production of all final goods and services, the count at market rate without the duplication, we call it the national income. And currently the Central Statistical Organization, means CSO, they collect and publish the data of national income every year in India, and India's financial year start from the 1st April to 31st March, and national income we count the base year, the 2011 year. So in general, national income refer to the total income earned by the normal resident of the nations during a given time. As a result, their productive services in generally the given time is the 1 year, from 1st April to 31st March. And we also call the primary, secondary and tertiary sectors are produce new goods and services. We calculate the total amount of new products in all sectors of economy is given period and edit it. We can roughly say that it is national income. The sum of the all three sectors, primary, the secondary and tertiary sectors, we call it the national income. So three sectors, production and sum, means the agriculture sector's share, the industry sector shares, and the service sector share. So sum of the all three sectors production, we call the, it is the national income. So we here looking the circular flow of income two sector model. Circular flow means the income is a flow in circular flow in the economy. Circular flow of income is the basic concept in macroeconomics. The concept of circular flow is given clear-cut picture of the economy, how the income is circularly flow from one sector to the other sector, like the farm sector to household sector and household sector to farm sectors. The meaning of the circular flow of income. The circular flow of income and expenditure refer to the process wherever the national income and expenditure of an economy flow in circular manner continuously through the time. So income is continuously circularly flow from one sector to another sector and another sector to first sector. It is a circular flow of income and expenditure, the two sectors, between the household sector and the farm sector. So the circular flow of income and expenditure means this circular flow of the income between the two sector. It is a represented two sector model. So circular flow, the income is the flow in circular manner in the economy. It's called the circular flow of the economic nature. So surplus flow of income, two sector model in the economy, money is used in the process of exchange, and the national income is the net production of goods and services produced in particular period. So in the economy, the process of exchange of national income, net production of goods and services production in particular year is the, considered in national income. The income of a nation is after all the income earned by all citizens of the nation, but not every family today make goods or sells in the make and earn and income by selling them. So the income of the nation, after all the income earned by all citizens of the country is considered, but every family it not make goods and sells market, but they earn the income as a factor rewards and they selling to the their factors to the firm sectors or industrial sectors and earn income, and the factories produce goods and services and selling to the families. Circular flow of income can be determined as follows in two sectors economy. There are the family, household, or the firm and business sector. So two sectors exist in the economy. We call it the family or household is the first sector, the other sector is the firm or business. So income is equal to C plus I, where the Y is the national income, C means the consumption, and I means investment. So income is the sum of the C plus I. So first we see the features of the family. What is the family? The families are owner of the all factors of production. The factor of production of means that the land, labor, capital, and the entrepreneur or organizers. The total income consists wage, rent, interest, and profit. So all the factors of production receive their reward or income, means the land get the rent, the workers get the salary or wages, the capital get the interest, and the profit for the organizer and entrepreneurs. And they are the consume all consumer goods and services which is produced by the business and firms. So families, the owners of the factors of production, land, labor, capitals, they receive the remuneration and reward, wages, rentes, interest, and the profit, and they are the consume the goods and services which is produced by the firms and business. They spend their total income on goods and services produced by the firms. If they save the part of their income, they invest in the firms. So they not save their income, they invest into the firm. So household is the having there some features. The business or the firms also have the some features. The businesses, the no resources of their own, they just collect the resources and produce the goods. And they hire and use the factor of production, land, labor, and capital from the household or the families. So business and firm, the no resources of their own, but they hire the resources, land, labor, capital from the household and families and produce the goods and services. They produce and sell goods and services to the household and receive the income in monetary form or money form. They do not say that there is and no the corporation saving. So there is no saving from the business sides and no saving from the family sides. And it is the circular manner, the flow, the income from one sector to other sectors. Assumption for this circular flow, there are only two sectors in the economy. One is the household and another is the firm sector. The second assumption, the government does not influence in the economic activity, means not impose the taxation or not give the subsidy in economy. So government does not influence in the economic activities. It is a closed economy, which means no export and import. So it is a closed economy where the only two sectors, household and firm sectors. Families can't save. So they can't save, they hold income spent on their goods and services. The firms distribute all production, firms not use the some production for their self-consumption, they distribute the all production. Every economy is in a cyclical flow of income. So every economy sees a cyclical flow of income. These are the assumptions for the circular flow of income and expenditure. So explanation of the circular flow of national income: the household and family spend their total income on the goods and services produced by the firms, and they do not hold any part of their income in the saving form. So entire income received by the families spend for the goods and services, they not hold some part of the income in form of saving. The firm produce goods and services only as much as demanded by the household. They do not maintain any inventory or stock. So business and firms not they maintain any stock. The whole production which is the produced, they sold in the market, not reserve some part of their production. The firm make the pattern of payment to the household in the form of rent, wages, interest and the profit. So firm give the payment to capital owners, means the families and household, the rent, wages, interest and profit form. There is no inflow or outflow income or goods and services from any outside sources. So there is no export and import. This assumption is in specific two sector and three sector model also. So there is no import, export and external sectors inflow these two sectors model. So what is about the circular flow of national income? Basic assumption is one sector's the expenses is the another sector is the income, and another sector's income, the first sector is the expenses. So that is why it's called the income expenditure circular flow also. So we see this flow with help of this diagram. So families is the one side and another side is the firm. So firm is produce goods and services and provide into the product market, and families provide the land, labor and capital, enterprises entrepreneur in the partner market, and firm give the payment to the families in the form of rent, wages, interest and profit in factor market. So families sold their factors, land, labor, capital and entrepreneurs in the factor markets and received income in the form of rent, wages and the interest. So flow is from the families to firms and firms to family. With the help of this land, labor, capital and entrepreneurs, the firm produce goods and services and selling into the product market to the families. So they selling the goods and services to family, firm produce goods and services and selling to the family, and families purchase the goods and services and give payment to the firms. So this is the circular flow of income and expenditure from one sector to the other sectors and other sector to first sectors. So income is the flow in the circular manner from the one sector to the other sector. It is called the circular flow of income or expenditure. Now the diagram we can explain here. There are the two clear cut sectors. One sector we call the family, and there is a firm or industry, and there are the two market, factor market and product market. The families, they sold their factors in the factor markets, land, labor, capital, and the entrepreneurs, land, labor, capital and entrepreneurs or organizers, and firms giving the reward to these factors, the rent to be given to the land, the wages and salary due to the labor, interest to the capital and profit to the entrepreneur or organizers. With the help of these four factors, land, labor, capital and entrepreneur organizers, firm produce goods and services and available into this product market for the family's consumption. Family purchase the goods and services in product market and give money to the firm. So this circular manner flow the income and expenditure in economy. So there is a two sectors, the families or household and firms. So families and firm, there are the two sectors. So circular flow of income, they circulate in the economy, they circulate manner. So that's why it's called the circular flow of income and expenditure. So it is the circular flow of income and expenditure, and we explain this is with the help of the diagram. So I have found for these circular flow of income and expenditure. The goods and services are purchased at specific price from the firms to meet the unlimited needs of families. That is, on the one hand, and the demand and supply flow of goods and services begin, while on the other, the flow of money is begin. So goods and services purchased by the families from the firms for the completing their needs, and one hand the demand for these goods and the firms produce the goods and supply for these goods and services. So circular flow is begin in this way in the form of money. The combination, the combined relation between the supply and demand flow, goods and services, and the flow of money is whole is called the circular flow of income. So the combined relation between the supply and demand, the firm's supply or the demand of household, or the demand of firms and supply of household, these supply demand flow of goods and services and flow of money whole is called the cycle flow of income. This flow is known as the bi-regional model, as is operate between the families and firms. So these are the highlight point between the circular flow of income and expenditure. Some also we see the highlight point. The similarly, economy show the cyclical flow of income in the three or four sectors. The role of government is clearly in the three sector model, while the four sector model include the international trade. So this is the two sector models. When we add the another sector is the government, is the three sector model. When we add the international trade, export import, is become a four sector model. According to these, the goods and services and money are exchanged between the families and business, government and international trade, and the circular flow of income is begin. So according to goods and services and money are exchanged between the family and business, government and international trade, in circular flow income begin in the four sector model. Finally, we can conclude that this, the flow of income continue in the production, is the continuous activity due to the never ending of human wants. So it is the continuous activity from one sector to the other sectors. The income is flow in circular manner. That's why it's called the circular flow of income and expenditure two sector model. So here we look at the two sector models. Some of the things is the reasons, or some of the things is responsible adding to the circular flow, and some of the things are responsible for the withdrawal from the circular flow. When the people are save the money, or the firms save the money, that time the circular flow is reduced, and the that time it is become a narrow. And when the some of the thing inject in this flow, like the investment and the export, that time the circular flow is become wider or more. So some of the things is responsible for the adding to the circular flow, and some of the things is the responsible for the reducing the circular flow. When the family is the import the goods from the other firms, other countries, that time this flow will be reduced. And when they export the firm, that time circular flow is increased. And when the saving is done by both family and the firms, the circular flow is reduced. And when the government invests or given the subsidy to family or the firm, that time the expenditure increase and increase the income, and that's why they increase the circular flow of income and expenditure. So here we end the circular flow of income and expenditure two sector model. When the income is circulated in the economy in circular manner from one sector to another sector, it's called the circular flow of income and expenditure. There is a two sector, firm and industry. References for your study: Emerging Macroeconomic Theory, HLRJ Macroeconomic Theory, Devak and Navalkar Modern Economic Theory, and textbooks Rasa RG, SP Ada, SK Botekar, KS Golay, Business Economics, Macro, SEM 3, SEM 4, Prashant Publication, Jalga. This book is available in market and the library for your study. So these books you can refer for your study. The next is the assignment question on this topic. There is a very important IMP question. The every time asked on this topic, write a short note on circular flow of income to sector model. So this question you can write with the help of diagram. So there is a necessary to draw the circular flow of income expenditure to sectors in the circular manner and draw this diagram and explain the points. So meaning of the circular flow, assumption of circular flow, diagram and explanation is expected in this question. So thank you for watching this video. Here is the end of our topic number 2, national income. Next time we will see the next topic. Thank you.